start by thanking our prize sponsors. We were fortunate enough to get donations of gift cards and other things from the Cheesecake Factory, from J. Marsh Photography, Sky Zone, Starbucks, Philadelphia Runner, The Fresh Grocer. And we're really delighted to have these companies as our partners for the prizes that we're going to be able to give today, some of the prizes. And I also want to take a moment to thank my amazing, super duper amazing 5K planning team, who basically made this all possible. And I just want to thank Janet. Wave your hand, Janet. Holton. Roseanne. And Grace. Grace is always in the background helping us. So when you get those text messages and reminders and all those things, Grace, my assistant, has really been super helpful in that. So that's the 5K planning team, and we're really just so happy to have had such a marvelous team. So today we really want to talk about what Miles for Malawi is all about and why we did Miles for Malawi, and then we're going to just go into the awards. We're not going to be with you guys long. We're going to be done before 5 o'clock. Most of us together, and as you know, we work in Malawi, Africa, so we focus on 5 key focus areas: Christian outreach, economic empowerment, education, agriculture, and healthcare. And so our whole goal is to work together with the people that we serve and together with people just like you to transform the lives of children and families in rural Malawi so that they're not just surviving, but they're thriving. And one of the things we do is we raise money for the programs in Malawi. And this year we decided to do the Miles for Malawi virtual 5K. We've done a 5K before, but it's usually been in person. And so this year we did a virtual one because, one, it just keeps us safer from COVID. And then two, we just realized we have such a huge reach. And sometimes when you are bound by one geographic area, you can't always involve as many people. So this time we were able to involve people from all over the US.
Hey everyone, I'm coming to you from beautiful Asheville, North Carolina, and I am participating in the Pomoza International Virtual 5K. We wanted to just thank you for all your donations to help support the work that Pomoza is doing in Northern Malawi. So please feel free to continue to donate tonight to our work. And we're and keep up to date on all the things that we are doing. Thank you.
Yes, Missy Animtika. Walking. Joining me. You see, okay, here we go.
Okay, that's Mike Mtika walking. He was supposed to walk in Malawi, but he could not do it, so he's doing it right here, trying to make sure he does his 5K before tomorrow. So he's doing it today, and I'm just joining him. So thank you all people who supported him. Yes, he's so happy. Thank you for your support. Thank you. Bye-bye.
So right now, take a moment. I want you to put in the chat where you did your 5K, if you did a 5K, where you did your 5K. Some of us, like I said, are in Jamaica. We have people participating from Connecticut. We have people in North Carolina. So quickly put in there where you did your 5K, if you did your 5K with us. But we were really excited that we were able to get so many people involved. And not be limited by just a small area. I also want to acknowledge that one of the reasons we did Miles for Malawi was to draw attention to the many distances that people walk in rural Malawi for basic necessities. Here's an image, a typical image of rural Malawi. And you have people walk for everything, to get water, to get firewood, to get, you know, to go to the nearest hospital. In our case, the nearest hospital is about 6 to 7 miles away. So one way is just 6 to 7 miles if they have to go there and come back. And most of that is by foot. On the right here, you see this image that we created of some of the common distances that people are walking. 1 mile, one way to go get safe water, you know, to church, 2 miles, to high school, the nearest high school, 4 miles. Some people are walking 5 to 7 miles just to go to high school. So we have common distances that people are walking all the time, and it's not close. And there's one of the facts that we had shared early on in the 5K is that we serve about 32,000 people. In our catchment, there's about 32,000 people. And out of that 32,000 people, there's fewer than 5 families. We actually could only identify one family, but we say, well, let's just imagine maybe there's more than this one family we know, that there's fewer than 5 families who own a car. So the primary mode of transportation is walking. They walk everywhere. So this was our effort to highlight and raise awareness about those distances, and then to raise money so we can bring programs closer to home so that people in rural Malawi don't have to walk so far to get these basic necessities. And we were able to raise $15,000 or more. Okay, you can shake your hands, you can give a thumbs up, you can use your Zoom icons. Now there's like a million of them, just to show how amazing this is. Celebrate with us. $15,000, more than $15,000, a little bit more, towards the programs in Malawi. And what does $15,000 mean? Here it might mean, I don't know, half of a car, maybe a used car, I have no idea. But $15,000 in rural Malawi is significant, and it goes really far. With this money, we can support 10 students to go to high school. High school is not free. So we offer scholarships so students can go to high school. Most of the time, if they don't go to high school, they just drop out after 8th grade and they get married. But if we provide scholarships, it helps them to get more educated and delay early marriages. We can provide 5 college scholarships. We can help 300 students get breakfast each school day. We can provide medicine at our clinic, 5 weeks worth, 100 Bibles translated into Tumbuka, the local language. We can support 10 families to help them out of food insecurity through our food security program. All of these things can be done with just $15,000. So the impact of every dollar raised through Miles for Malawi is huge. And I just want to thank you, thank you, thank you for your partnership in this work. That's my spiel, guys. I didn't have too much more to say beyond the fact that, you know, this is really important work that you're part of, and we appreciate your partnership. But now we want to get to the fun part, which is announcing people who won certain things from our 5K. So I'm going to pass it off to Roseanne.
Just want to thank all our participants and all our supporters, because without their efforts, this would not have been possible. Also want to, you know, send out a big shout out to Tamwa, Janet, Grace, Colton, round of applause, you know, for their tireless work, you know, in carrying this, you know, effort forward. I mean, we could not have done it without your, you know, leadership and your support. And with that said, I would just like to announce the medal winners. We have almost 50 participants, ranging from ages 7, the youngest, to 73. And everyone so far that I have spoken with have indicated that they had a wonderful time. So we have winners in 4 categories, age 2 to 19, 20 to 34, 35 to 49, and 50 to 99. So we have gold, silver, and bronze medalists. So I'll start off now with the youngest age group, 2 to 19. So bronze winner goes to Sawyer King with a time of 31 minutes and 15 seconds. Round of applause, please. Then the silver medal in the 2 to 19 age group goes to Samuel Wright with a time of 28 minutes and 41 seconds. And gold place finisher goes to Leo Amorim with a time of 21 minutes and 21 seconds. Thank you all to our age group 2 to 19. Next, we have age group 20 to 34. Bronze goes to Margaret Fleming with a time of 2 hours. Silver medalist is Laura Elwood with a time of 28 minutes and 38 seconds. And gold finisher goes to Joseph Elwood, 21 minutes and 59 seconds. Yay! That's my age group. Just kidding. And we have age group 35 to 49, bronze finisher with a time of 33 minutes and 34 seconds, Sarvelia Peralta Duran. Silver finisher medalist with a time of 33 minutes and 26 seconds is our own Tamara, right? Woo! And our gold finisher is Sabine Oberbeck with a time of 28 minutes and 57 seconds. Round of applause, please. Finally, we have the age group 50 to 99. And our bronze finisher is Doug Pennock with a time of 1 hour and 10 minutes. And next we have our own Holton Falk with a time of 1 hour and 54 minutes. Go Holton! And finally, last but not least, we have the gold place finisher in this age group, 50 to 99, Eric Nordgren, with a time of 37 minutes and 6'7". Congratulations to all our participants and all our medal winners. Thank you all. And now I'll turn it over to Holton.
In addition to our speed categories, we have some more unusual categories. So let me go through those. There are five special prizes we have. And I'll just start with the youngest and work my way through them. So our youngest participant is Tegan King, age 7.
Tegan!
Now, Tegan wins some jump passes to Sky Zone. This is an OPA, and we're hoping he really enjoys those. For the other end of the spectrum, we have the master finisher, Sandley Donnelly, at 73 years young.
Sandy!
I like that persistence. Way to go, Sandy. Now we have a gift certificate to Olive Garden for Sandy. For best photo, can you bring that up? There it is. Look at that. Isn't that a beautiful photo? We like that. Matching poses. Saravilia and Eric Nordgren get the best photo award. Their prize is a free family photo shoot by J. Marsh Photography. Yay! Most funds raised, a terrific category for us. Angel Barrett, yes, wins that one with raising $1,200. Thank you, Angel. Yay! We have a gift card to the Cheesecake Factory for Angel.
Take me with you, Angel. We can go enjoy Cheesecake Factory. Woo woo! Nice.
And finally, our slow and steady category. Again, our winner is Angel Barrett.
Yay! Yay, Angel!
Way to go! Yeah, it's easy when you can do it quick. It's not so easy when you take your... when it takes some time to go through that. Again, another gift certificate.
We have two winners there. We have Angel, and we also have Jenny De La Cruz. So she had runner up for slowest time.
Great. So each of them gets a gift certificate to Starbucks for that. So thank you again for participating, for being part of a terrific prize. A terrific event, and for helping our brothers and sisters in Malawi.
And I do want to recognize one other winner. I think, where did I put him? Fastest time, Leo. Leo is on the right here. You see a picture. It's me, my son, Sam, who doesn't smile for photos, as you can see. And then Leo. And Leo got the fastest time overall. He actually participates in cross country at his school. So that makes sense. I think he ran it in 22 minutes or something. And he gets a $50 gift card to Philadelphia Runner. So congratulations to Leo. He's currently in France, but I'm sure he'll make use of that. Awesome. So we want to conclude by saying yewo. Everyone, I want you to repeat after me when I say yewo.
Yewo.
Yewo is one of those words we use for everything. It means thank you. It means hello. It means goodbye. But yewo, thank you so much for everyone. And as you've seen in our motto, we really believe in going together, right? We really believe that if you want to go fast, go alone. But if you want to go far, go Pomoza. And the medals that we're going to be giving to those people who are called that won the fastest time in their group category, it says there, go far, go Pomoza. Because it's really an important approach. We could not do this without each of you here who made time to be on this call, all the other participants who made time to participate in Miles for Malawi, raise funds and raise awareness. And I don't know if I omitted to say it, but we also have people in Malawi who are going to be participating in Miles for Malawi, but it's Miles in Malawi. More than 40 people have signed up to also walk and show just solidarity with us, just as we're doing for them. So we're super excited about that. And one of those people is gonna be, I want my mother and my father to wave and say hi on the camera, because they're going to be in Malawi with the participants walking. I think the goal is for them to walk 14 miles. That's going to be to the nearest hospital and back, and they're going to be documenting that. I think this is the most my father has ever walked. So we're going to be thinking of you. You want to say something about that?
Yeah, it's not true. That's the most I've walked.
In the last 10 years, that's the most he's walked.
Well, since I came to the US, yes, that's the most I've walked. But in the 1960s and 70s, boy, I walked. just to say that we were supposed to be in Malawi today, actually, no, yesterday, on the 25th of June. And we had all sorts of difficulties. So we were not able to go. And by God's grace, we should be leaving. We have rebooked ourselves. We should be leaving on July 1. And the staff in Malawi, the people in Malawi are ready to go. So they will be walking on July 1. Mm-hmm. I will not be there, but when I get there, we'll have a second walk so that I can prove that I can walk faster than them.
Amazing. Thank you so
much. Oh, we did walk here. We did walk here around, what's this place?
Like Upper Dabe
area. Upper Dabe area.
Yeah. And just so you know, because some of you guys have been following the work that Pomoza is doing for quite some time now, and we've been doing a lot of COVID prevention work. But the reason that my parents weren't allowed to travel is now they've basically banned travel. They're not allowing anyone into Malawi unless they're Malawian citizens and or have government permission to be there, because the COVID rates are back on the rise. So they've shut that down. So they sent my parents home from the airport until we could get that government letter authorizing them to get in. But we are doing some COVID work. We're continuing to do that because it just keeps going up and down. So that's just something for you to keep in mind, but that's part of the work that we are involved in, of course.
It's all about safety.
All about safety, yeah.
It's so all about safety. Just to say that it was so interesting. God has a way of intervening in tremendous ways. I connected with one person who connected with another person. Then they went on all the way to the Secretary for Health And he provided the letter to us within 3 hours of my speaking to him. And so it's just wonderful.
Beautiful.
And
beautiful.
Yeah, so that provided some connection to these high-level guys in Malawi.
Yes.
Now they know about Pamoza. There was a lot of talking about Pamoza with the president's office and the Minister of Health. Yeah, so.
A good thing. So we're going to let you guys go. If you won an award or a prize, you're going to get that in the mail. We want you to continue to sporting your Pamoza shirt. I forgot to put mine on. I've been in a mess with, I'm on vacation brain. But please continue to sport your Pamoza shirt so people can see that very important message about going far together. If you didn't get one because you didn't participate, let me know and we'll make sure you get a Pamoza shirt as well later on. So let's finish with our motto. I'm going to ask different people and I'm going to see if you remember what the motto is, okay? I'm going to start with little Angel. Angel, what's the motto? If you want to go fast.
If you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go Pamoza.
That's right. Okay. Yay. All right, guys. Yewo, thank you so much.
Yewo, thanks. Yewo.
Now I see
you. Oh, now you see it, Anne.
Okay. Enjoy your vacation and safe travels, Mike and Annie.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. God bless you. Bye-bye.